Hey guys, heating iodine with bromine up to the point of a deliquation of the wall mass and its later cooling results in the formation of an interhalogen compound known as iodine monobromide. It is a dark red solid. This bottle contains 100 grams of iodine monobromide. Now I'll open it and show you how the reagent looks like. Iodine monobromide resembles elemental iodine. However, iodine monobromide is volatile at room temperature, and unlike elemental iodine, it has these distinctive heavy dark orange vapors that you can observe right now. This is how iodine monobromide crystals look at a very close range. At melting point, iodine monobromide changes into a red-brown liquid with a strong smell of bromine. Here, iodine monobromide vapors cool down on the cold tube walls, forming beautiful crystals. And now it's time to demonstrate the chemical properties of this reagent. When heated, iodine monobromide reacts with concentrated sulfuric acid that oxidizes it to bromine, reducing to sulfur dioxide in process. When reacting with alkali solution, iodine monobromide forms bromide, iodide and iodate salts. All three of them are colorless. That's why, unlike the previous reaction, the solution in this one has no color. Hydrazine hydrate very actively reduces iodine bromide to elemental iodine, hence the vast amount of purple smoke that we can see here. The reaction of potassium with melted iodine monobromide results in an explosion. Copper powder reacts with melted iodine monobromide pretty actively too, but there is no explosion. Red phosphorus combusts on contact with it. And antimony powder reacts with solid iodine bromide instantly. You all know that aluminum reacts with bromine and iodine quite violently, so let's check its interaction with iodine bromide. Thanks for watching, guys, don't forget to give this video a like if you enjoyed it, and I'll do my best to make another one, but next time with much more active iodine monochloride. See you in the next video.